So, if you are looking to buy a new laptop around the price of 65,000 rupees but confused as there are a lot of options to choose from, then watch the full video and I'm going to help you find the perfect laptop under 65,000 rupees. Before starting, if you are new here and you end up liking the video, make sure to hit the subscribe button and give some feedback. So let me first tell you how I have prepared this list and what can you expect in this price. So I have included a powerful gaming laptop as well as the lightweight ultrabooks, and to make this list I have given priority to a laptop with SSD or a hybrid storage and ignore the laptops which are not in stock right now. So the first laptop in my list is Acer Nitro 5. So this laptop is having an Intel i5 9th generation processor. It is an quad core CPU with 8 threads with base frequency of 2.4 GHz and a turbo boost frequency of 4.1 GHz. And it is having 8 MB of cache memory. And this CPU is paired with very powerful NVIDIA's GTX 1650 with 4GB of VRAM. So combined, this setup is pretty much capable to handle any game at 1080p. Coming to the RAM, this laptop is having 8GB of DDR4 RAM. And you have the option to upgrade the RAM up to 32GB. For storage, you get a hybrid setup here. It is having a very fast NVMe M.2 SSD with a storage capacity of 256GB and then 1TB of hard disk. And upgradability is not an issue here. Talking about the screen, it is having a 15.6 inch of 1080p screen, which is an IPS panel with 60Hz of refresh rate. And it covers 57% of sRGB color gamut and 36% of Adobe RGB. Coming to the keyboard, you will see a full-size keyboard here with number pad, and it is a backlit keyboard, but it's not RGB, it's single red color. Coming to the ports, on one side you will see two full-size USB 3.0 and Type-C port, an HDMI port and an RJ45 LAN port. On the other side, there's single USB 2.0 and a 3.5mm headphone jack. In terms of build quality, this laptop is fully made with plastic and it weighs around 2.3 kg. For cooling, this laptop is having a dual fan design with two heat pipes, and during load it will crank up the fans and you will definitely hear it. For battery, this laptop is having a 4-cell battery with 55 watt hours of capacity. So you can expect about 4 or 5 hours of battery with mixed usage. So overall, if you want a very powerful laptop for gaming or machine learning with good battery backup, then this will be a very good laptop for you. And the next laptop in my list is a newly launched convertible laptop from Asus. I'm talking about Asus VivoBook Flip 14. So this laptop is powered by Ryzen 5 4th generation processor. It is an hexa-core CPU with base frequency of 2.3 GHz and it can go up to 4.0 GHz with 8 MB of cache memory. In short, it is a very powerful processor, and like every other Ryzen processor, it also comes with integrated Radeon Vega 6 graphics. So this is not a gaming laptop, but it will easily handle your casual gaming sessions. Coming to the RAM, this laptop is having an 8GB of DDR4 RAM, and if you want, you can upgrade it to 12GB. For storage, it is having a very fast NVMe M.2 SSD with a storage capacity of 512GB, and if you want more, you can swap the SSD with a larger one. Talking about the screen, this laptop is having a 14-inch of 1080p screen, which is an IPS panel, and it is a touchscreen with 60Hz of refresh rate, and it covers 60% of sRGB and 38% of Adobe RGB. For keyboard, it is having a backlit keyboard, but it doesn't have a number pad. Coming to the ports, on one side you will see a full-size USB 3.2, an HDMI port, and Type-C port, and 3.5mm headphone jack, and micro SD reader, and then a barrel charging port. And on the other side, there's single USB 2.0. If we talk about its build quality, this laptop is having a very good aluminum build, and it will feel very sturdy to the hand. And as a convertible laptop, you can rotate the screen by 360 and use it as a tablet. And this laptop weighs 1.5 kg. For cooling, this laptop is having a single fan to cool down the laptop. It will be enough as there's no dedicated GPU. And the fan will run silent comparatively without any noise. For battery, this laptop is having a 3-cell battery with 48 watt hours of capacity. So you can expect about 5 hours of battery with mixed usage. So overall, if you want a powerful convertible laptop or a lightweight ultrabook with a touchscreen, then this laptop will be a very good choice for you. So the next laptop in my list is Asus TUF A15. This laptop is powered by Ryzen 5 4th generation processor. It has a 6-core CPU with 12 threads with a base frequency of 3.3 GHz and it can go up to 4.4 GHz with 8 MB of cache memory. In short, it is a very powerful processor, or you can also say that it is the most powerful processor at this price. And this powerful processor is paired with NVIDIA's GTX 1650 Ti with 4GB of VRAM. So this combination is capable to handle any game at 1080p. Coming to the RAM, this laptop is having 8GB of DDR4 RAM and you have the option to upgrade the RAM up to 32GB. For storage, you get an hybrid setup here. It is having a very fast NVMe M.2 SSD with a storage capacity of 256GB and then 1TB of hard disk. And you have the option to upgrade it. Talking about the screen, it is having a 15.6 inch of 1080p screen, which is an IPS panel with 144Hz of refresh rate. And it covers 45% of sRGB color gamut, which is not very color accurate, but for gaming, it's fine. Coming to the keyboard, you will see a full-size keyboard here with number pad, and yep, it's an RGB backlit keyboard. Coming to the ports, on one side you will see two full-size USB 3.2 and Type-C port, an HDMI port, and 3.5mm headphone jack, and an RJ45 LAN port. And on the other side, there's single USB 2.0. In terms of build quality, this laptop is made with plastic and metal, and it is having military grade durability rating. So it's a laptop with a good build, and it weighs around 2.3 kilograms. For cooling, this laptop is having a dual fan design with two heat pipes with self-cleaning technology, and this variant has mixed reviews in terms of cooling. And under load, you will definitely hear the fan noise. For battery, this laptop is having a 3-cell battery with 48 watt-hours of capacity. So you can expect about 3 hours of battery with mixed usage. So overall, if you want a very powerful laptop for gaming or machine learning, then this can be a very good choice for you. And the last laptop in my list is a lightweight Ultrabook. I'm talking about Mi Notebook Horizon. So this laptop is having an Intel i7 10th generation processor, which is a quad core processor with 8 threads. It is having 8MB of cache memory with a base frequency of 1.8 GHz and a turbo boost frequency of 4.9 GHz. And even though this is a lightweight Ultrabook, it is having a dedicated GPU. More specifically, Nvidia's MX350, and it will be enough for your casual gaming session. And for RAM, you are getting 8GB of DDR4 RAM, and it is soldered to the motherboard. So there's no room for expansion. And for storage, you get a very fast NVMe M.2 SSD with a storage capacity of 512GB. And if you want, you can swap it with a larger one. Coming to its screen, this laptop is having a 14-inch of 1080p display. Of course, it's an IPS panel, but I couldn't find any details regarding color accuracy. Coming to the keyboard, it doesn't have a number pad, and also it's not a backlit keyboard. And also another thing this laptop lacks is the webcam, but Xiaomi will give you an external webcam with the laptop. Coming to the ports, on one side you will see two full-size USB 3 and Type-C port, an HDMI port, and an barrel charging port. And on the other side, there's a single USB 2.0 and then a 3.5mm headphone jack. If you talk about its build quality, this laptop is having a metal build and it will feel very sturdy, and it weighs around 1.3 kilograms. For cooling, this laptop is having a single fan to cool down both GPU and CPU. And for battery, this laptop is having a 4-cell battery with 48 watt-hours of capacity. So you can expect about 5 or 6 hours of battery with mixed usage. So overall, if you need a lightweight laptop with a powerful CPU and you want to play casual games, and a backlit keyboard is not important to you, then this laptop can be very good choice for you. So these are all the laptops which I think are very good to consider around the price of 65,000 rupees. If your budget is slightly higher or slightly lower, you can also check my other videos. So that's all from my side. Thumbs up if you liked the video, or thumbs down if you didn't. And let me know about your opinion in the comment section, or feel free to ask any question. Thanks, I will see you in the next video. Stay home, stay safe.